Love you. We are so glad that you invited us to your wedding.
Hey Todd, hey Rachel. We're super happy to be here in Cancun with you guys celebrating your wedding. Todd, we never thought you would get married, and we're just ecstatic that you found somebody that you love and that we got to meet her, and we love her just as much as we love you.
Todd and Rachel, this is for you. This is one of my happiest weekends ever. I've been looking forward to this, well, for 44 years since you were born, Todd, so here we are. And you couldn't have picked a more beautiful, fabulous woman. Rachel is going to make a great wife, and you two are going to be partners forever. I love you.
No, we're super happy for you guys. Todd, been with you for a long time, buddy, and super happy. Happy for you. Rachel seems like a great gal, and I know you're going to have a lot of great years together, and couldn't be happier for you. And salute to you guys. Cheers.
Salud.
Salud.
This woman to be married this afternoon. Thank you. And you can all be seated. And to each of you, on behalf of Todd and Rachel, welcome. And thank you for being here in this special place to celebrate with us. And as we come together, certainly, we're in an environment very different from what we're all accustomed to back home. We're in this very special place, and in fact, today it's serving as a very sacred place. And it's not just this physical setting that makes this space sacred, but it's your presence, the sacredness of each one of you that make this celebration what it is. As these two separate people come together to state their vows and to begin a life together as a married couple. And so, with the intention of honoring this space, I would invite each of you to pick up a handful of sand and hold it in your hand for just a moment. And as you rest with this earth in your hands, before you drop it, I would invite you to offer an intention, a quiet intention, bringing honor to the space, bringing honor to the celebration. And so at this time, release the sand that you hold. And with that, we will begin this special celebration. Together, we have all come for the purpose of celebrating and for joining Todd and Rachel as they enter into a deeper relationship, and to be with them and celebrate with them in the making of this important commitment. This is not a commitment they enter into lightly. It's a commitment that they've considered for a good while, and they've chosen this place at this time. The essence of this commitment is in taking another person in his or her entirety as lover, as companion, and most importantly, as friend. It's therefore a decision that's not to be made lightly, but rather undertaken with great consideration and respect for both oneself as well as the other person. Love is one of the highest experiences that we human beings can have. We human beings, love is one of the highest experiences that we can have. It adds depth and meaning to our lives. And the central part of love is one of life's greatest joys. And when this central part is combined with real friendship, the pleasure in doing things together or in doing things and separately and rejoicing to exchange experiences when they come back together, this is a continuous and central part of what two individuals who love one another share in this special relationship. Marriage symbolizes the intimate sharing of two lives. Yet this sharing must not diminish, but enhance the individuality of each partner. A marriage that lasts is one that continues to develop as each person continues to develop and also grow in deeper understanding of the other. Deep knowledge of another is not something that can be attained in a short time, and real understanding can only come with years of intimacy. This wonderful knowledge of another person grows out of really caring so much that one wants to understand completely as possible, just what the other is feeling. Thus, it's possible to share not only joys and successes, but also the burden of sorrows and failures. Thank you. To be known in this way is a priceless thing, because such understanding and acceptance make it easier to live together in peace and happiness. So while marriage is the intimate sharing of two lives, it can yet enhance the uniqueness of each partner. We must give ourselves, Rachel and Todd, in love, but we must not give ourselves away. A good and balanced relationship is one in which neither person is overshadowed or absorbed by the other. Thus, it's out of the tension between the separateness and the union that love, whose incredible strength is equal only to its incredible fragility, is born and reborn. So we're here then this day to celebrate the love which you two have for each other and to give social recognition. We are the ones giving social recognition to your mutual decision to accept each other into the state of matrimony. And to do that, we're going to state some vows. And at this time, I'd like to invite Linda to join us.
Why marriage? Because to the depths of me, I long to love one person with all my heart, my soul, my mind, my body. Because I need a forever friend to trust with the intimacies of me, who won't hold them against me, who loves me when I'm dislikable, who loves me and sees the small child in me, and who looks for the divine potential of me. Why marry? Because I need to cuddle in the warmth of the night with someone who is grateful for me, with someone I feel blessed to hold. Because marriage means opportunity to grow in a relationship. Why marriage? Because marriages do not fail, people fail. When they enter into a marriage, expecting another to make them whole. Because knowing this, I promise myself to take full responsibility. For my spiritual, mental, and physical wholeness, I create me. I take half of the responsibility for my marriage. Together, we create a marriage. Why marriage? Because with this understanding, the possibilities are limitless.
Thank you, Linda. So what Linda has shared with us is the question of why marriage. And this is something that they have been faced with over these past months and year as they've considered today and coming together. At this time, I would like to invite the 14 of you who are going to help us with vows to come forward and form a circle just behind the little structure here. And so, as we all know, Rachel and Todd are great volleyball players. In fact, I think that's maybe a part of your coming together.
Yeah.
And I know in volleyball, to determine who goes first, there's typically a volley. But it's too damn hot to enter into a volley. But what we thought we would do is the good old coin toss. Excellent. And so I have a peso here that I'm going to flip. And you get to call. And whoever wins the toss gets to decide who goes first with their vow. Is that fair?
Yes.
Okay. Let's see if I can catch it. Do you want to call it?
Tails never fails.
All right, Rachel's called tails, and heads it is.
Oh!
Oh, so this, go first, this is the beginning.
I get to choose.
Oh, that's how it works.
Aren't you paying attention
to
the referee?
Okay, so Todd has chosen to go first with the ballot.
And so, why don't I go first?
That's a great name.
It's like the Steelers.
You're going to go first?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. And so the first vow is being presented by Jeff. There you are.
I'm gonna hug you too.
Love you. Slide off and it's purple.
Just for you, babe.
Yeah. Alright. Babe?
Yeah.
I promise to always set you the best.
Okay, babe, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm going to hold that to you. Especially when we play tournaments.
Oh.
That's what Stella is.
Just come through there.
There you go.
Okay. I love you too. Thank you.
You want to hug me too? Thank you.
Todd, I promise to respect you as your own person and realize that your interests, desires, and needs are no less important than my own. As much as we love doing the same things, I know that we both have some of our own things too, which I will respect and admire.
Well, one hit a chord.
I want one of those.
I thought it was a good one.
Start off with a bang, huh?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Kelly did too.
All right. Babe.
You ready?
You
go back down.
Okay.
You go back down and sit down.
You hurt yourself.
Oh, no. Babe,
go ahead and sit down.
But Todd,
hey,
loud.
I'm going to.
Like just, you're proud.
Hey, settle down.
Like you're proud.
Babe, this is another funny one. I promise to love you, even if the Broncos are losing.
I think that's a wise choice.
No kissing yet.
Oh, sorry. No kissing.
And Robin.
Even if I'm totally winning. Okay, unless we are playing rummy, then I'm totally keeping score since you're kind of a card shark and you beat me frequently in cards.
You're funny.
And Tyler.
All right.
Go back.
It's time to get serious.
Oh, it is. Now it's serious time.
Take care of her, Todd. Okay. I vow to fiercely love you in all forms for now and forever. Sorry.
I promise to give you the best of myself and in return ask no more than you can give. You are so generous, kind, and loving. You make me want to be a better person and treat you with the same generosity, kindness, and love that you deserve.
I promise to hold you, protect you, and care for you. I promise to hold your hand, make you smile. I promise to wipe your tears. I promise to help you grow into the beautiful woman that you were meant to be, and I promise to grow along with you. I also promise that my love for you will never stop growing.
That was a tearjerker.
Guys, I love you.
Oh,
sorry.
wedding.
And you see now, if this ever happens, make him hear his wife has really cheese stick with
you. Okay.
Top. I promise to make sure I'm not hungry and maybe need to eat a sandwich before I yell at you. I'll try not to be grouchy at you when you order the wrong food for me, especially on Sassy Saturdays.
Your crispy noodles with your hot toast. They're all good after that point. So. Alright, babe. I vow to be honest, truthful, and faithful for eternity. I vow to love you with all my heart and serve you in every way I can. I promise I will be by your side for every breath you take in all the days of our lives.
That was like six promises. You cheated. Oh, wait, I'm not keeping this one.
I love you so much.
It's fine. I promise always to be your friend, your faithful partner, and if I'm lucky, make you laugh every day like you do for me.
Almost over. That's a good one. My future wife, my lover, my best friend. I promise to cherish you, respect you, and love you unconditionally. I vow to love you no matter what challenges that you might carry us apart, and we'll always find our way back to each other.
I knew you were going to sell me that. Mm-hmm. Thank you. I promise to try and be more tidy and make the bed every day since you do all the laundry.
Are you sure?
I'm going to try. I said I promised I would try. But you have to keep color coding my closet if I have to make the bed every day. And all bets are off when the dogs won't get out of the bed for me to make it. You know how they run our lives.
Exactly.
I only wish that you did. That's exactly what I've always wanted.
I know, Mama. You're the best. Okay. Thank you.
And then meet your mother.
Honey, I promise to never forget that this was a once-in-a-lifetime crazy. I can't even say it.
Do you need my tissue?
No. I promise to never forget that this is a once-in-a-lifetime crazy forever kind of love, Rachel Elaine. I give you my heart, my life, my soul, and I become one with you.
Todd, I promise to never forget how special our love is. The crazy forever kind of love. It's once in a lifetime love, and it requires work, which I will do every day so that I never stop falling in love with you. I love you today, and I will love you for the rest of our days.
Alright, can I kiss her yet?
And so they have declared their vows before us. They have married one another. And at this time, I would invite you to reflect on this poem that comes from the early 1900s, a time when your great-grandfather was but a child. And so let me share this with you, and then we'll move into the ring ceremony and wrap it up. Sounds good. Love one another. Love one another. But they make not a bond of love. Let it be rather a moving sea between the shores of your soul. True love gives nothing but itself. And it takes nothing from itself. Love does not possess, nor would it be possessed. It can't be possessed. For love is sufficient unto love. Love has no other desire, none other, no other desire, but to fulfill itself, to awake at dawn with a winged heart and give thanks for another day of loving. One more day of loving. To rest at noon and mediate love's ecstasy. To return home at evening with gratitude. And then, and only then, with a prayer for the beloved in your heart, the beloved that exists within you, a song and a song of praise upon your lips to love one another. With that, you have made your declaration. And now I would invite you to give to me the symbol that you've chosen.
Which
we think we have here. Yes.
Oh, no, we have enough. I think it's fallout.
Don't come over here.
Wait. I could have sworn it's not fallout.
The ring fell.
What ring fell?
I just untied them.
Which wing fell?
No, whatever. I saw something fall.
Shingalway.
Savvy, we can't walk in there. Savannah. It's too much stress, honey. It'll sweep up.
Do I go back in? Go ahead, back in.
Let's go over here and finish. Right. And then we'll
just
search.
Come forward a little bit.
And then we'll search.
Otherwise, people can't see, like, all these people that are seeing.
So we'll be offering a reward afterwards. Is able to find
Do you want me to keep looking?
No. Go ahead. We'll exchange the rings we do have. And
that's why we got you two.
Right.
And so they have chosen a circle, a ring, symbolizing endless love. And again, this is one of those moments that we just made reference to, the challenges that you guys get to face together. So, Todd, I'm going to give you this ring, and I will go through your piece first, and then Rachel will present you with yours. So, Todd, you're saying to this dear woman who you've chosen as your wife,
I give you this ring.
As the pledge of my love.
The pledge of my love.
And it's the symbol of our unity.
And the symbol of our unity.
And you may place the ring on its finger. And Rachel.
I give you this ring, Todd.
As the pledge of my love.
As the pledge of my love.
And as the symbol of our unity.
And as the symbol of our unity.
You may place the ring on his finger. Okay. And if I have, may have your hand back together. As a witness, as friend, as family, I say to you, congratulations. It is this group that has witnessed your marriage of one another. I congratulate you and state to you my incredible respect through your choice to be partners with one another. And with that, you may kiss the bride.
We are grateful for this place in which we dwell, for the love that unites us, for the peace that's accorded us this day, for the hope for which we expect tomorrow, for the health, the work, the food, and the bright skies that make our lives delightful, for all our friends in all parts of the earth.
Thank you, John.
Thanks, Dad.
So I present to you, family and friends, Todd and Rachel Buslin.
I know.
We'll just have a couple of books.
Do you have any?
Is he sure it was in his pocket over here?
There you go. That's where you want to be, right there.
I found it. I found it.
Don't drop it again.
I lost it.
No song I could sing, and there is no combination of words I could say, but I will still tell you one thing, we're better together.
I had only hung out with Rachel a couple of times, and I went to her house one night, and I told her, hey, if you want to move in with me, you're more than welcome. And that was after a lot of drinks. And then a few days later, she called me, and it was 8 o'clock at night, and said, what is your address? Because I'm coming over and I have all of my stuff with me. And I thought, oh my God, I wasn't really being serious, but come on over. So I had to let Tyler know that someone he did not even know was moving into our house. And he was really understanding about it because he's a wonderful man. And at first, after Rachel moved in, it was a little awkward because we didn't know each other. She was living in my house. However, she just became my best friend and my sister wife, Tyler's wife, second wife. It was the best summer of Tyler's life. So Rachel has been one of the most selfless, gorgeous, hilarious women I've ever met. And she has really taught me what it's like to be a true adult non-high school friend. And I don't know Todd as well as I would like to. However, I have never seen Rachel as happy as she is today and how happy she has been over the last year and a half. I always told her that when you find the right guy, when you're not looking, and as cliche as it might sound, it was the truth for her. As fate would have it, she would fall in love on a car ride. I have always known and believed that when you find someone, you will know right away, and that is what happened. Rachel's relationship with Todd has been filled with such love, happiness, and support, and kindness towards each other. His family has welcomed them as their own, and I know that makes her feel amazing, and I am so thankful for all of you, and that is from the bottom of my heart. Knowing what amazing people Rachel and Todd are, I have no doubt they will have an amazing life together. Todd and Rachel, I love you very much, and I wish you a lifetime of happiness.
Beautiful.
apologize in advance. I'm having a bit of a Marilyn Monroe moment up here. So if anyone sees anything they shouldn't have, I'm sorry.
We're going to put it on YouTube. Don't worry.
For those that don't know me, I am Rachel's sister, half-sister, but we dropped the half a long time ago. And I am also the one that found the ring today, so. I just want to start by thanking Rachel and Todd for bringing us all to this beautiful island. I'm so thankful that we all made the journey safely, and I hope that everyone has had as wonderful time as I have. To get even closer?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like that microphone.
To Todd's family, it has been so great getting to know all of you. And I just want to thank you on behalf of myself and my dad and my mom, who couldn't be here, for welcoming my sister into your family and with open arms and making her feel so loved. So I appreciate that. To Rachel's friends, you all mean the world to my sister, and you truly have been like family to her. It's hard to be apart on holidays and other special occasions, but we take comfort in knowing that she's with people that love her and take care of her, and we really, truly support you for this. Thank you for the support system that you give her. I thought I took enough Xanax to not cry. Sorry. Okay, so Rachel, you've been such a huge part of my life and have truly guided me through many of life's moments. Along the way, you've given me some advice that has helped mold me into the woman that I am today, and I'd like to share some of my advice with you as you and Todd start in this journey through life together. Some of this may sound a little familiar. So here's a list. I'm a list maker. So number one, my advice is choose your battles. Let the things that matter bother you, and the things that don't matter, let them go. Anyone who's married here, or is about to be married, I think we all understand
that.
Yes. Number two, life is short. Don't waste it. Anything can happen at any day or any given moment, so make sure that you tell and show your loved ones how you feel. And for all of us that know Rachel, that's one of the things we love most about her. Number three, appreciate your mom and dad. They have always been there for us when we've needed them. Look around you, to all these people here, and know that all of us here are entering into this marriage with you because we love you. And I think we all can agree to that. It's okay to reach out to any one of us here in a time of need. We all love you and support you, and we want your marriage to be one that lasts a lifetime. Number four, it's okay to not agree. Sometimes you'll have to agree to disagree, and we don't always have to be right. That is the exact same advice that Rachel gave to me at 17 years old as I was graduating from high school.
Oh my God.
I've kept this letter that she wrote me very close to my heart. Shit. Sorry. And have referenced it often. I thought that it held the same value for your wedding day, since today is the start of a whole new chapter in your life together. You've both been given the opportunity today to start clean and fresh. The love you have for each other today is just the ground level. Let each day build upon the last. Finally, I just want to say how incredibly proud I am of you today. You look absolutely beautiful, and I'm not just saying that because I did her makeup, and I did do a phenomenal job, but she does look absolutely beautiful.
Yes.
Todd, I know I don't need to tell you how lucky you are to have my sister and this lady as your beautiful wife. You fell in love so quickly and couldn't get a ring on it fast enough. So without knowing much about you, I do know that of all things, you are a smart guy. You've made her so happy and have treated her like a princess, and that's exactly how she should be treated. As her vow stated to you, she will give to you the absolute best of herself and will not ask for any more than what you are capable of giving back. So, with that being said, Todd, don't take that for granted. One thing that my sister and I have in common is that we will always give 100% of ourselves to those that we love. Sometimes it hurts not getting 100% in return. All that I ask of you, Todd, is that you keep
the intention to not let her down. If you do, I am a 2.5 hour nonstop flight away from Detroit. I did do my research. And I am from Detroit, so you should all be very scared of me. And you don't want to know how accurate I am with the Glock 22. Plus, I'm pretty tight with law enforcement, so I'm really good at hiding dead bodies. And by the way, before anyone passes judgment on me for threatening Todd's life, Rachel did give me the okay to go ahead and threaten him. So, and, you know, we are Italian after all, and I think you got an easy pass when my dad just said, okay, you can go ahead and marry my daughter. So, from me to you, we do have connections to the mafia.
I mean, our uncle's the undertaker.
Yeah. In closing, I just want to say I could not be more happy for the two of you. Your wedding was absolutely beautiful, and I wish you a lifetime of happiness. Cheers.
That was, an awesome speech.
So I wanted to speak a little bit, shocker for most of you that know me, and I'm going to cry like a baby, so forgive me. I hope you brought some to touch up. First, Todd, and I want to thank all of you for making this journey with us. Todd and I are grateful for our families. All of us. All of you. Really. And we're truly grateful for our friends' loyalty. We have many friends here, and you all have been amazing. And like my sister said, you are family to me. We love all of you very much. And we couldn't imagine today without you in it. Uncle Kent, thank you for honoring us and making it special in a way no one could have. My dad and Cara, I love you. Thank you for making our trip. I know that it's in a tough time, and I truly am super heartbroken that Chris isn't here, but I hope that she be okay. My stepmom is ill at home and they chose to come here, and I am forever grateful. To my new family, Rich, Renee, Jamie, Ian, Ed, thank you for your generosity and your hospitality and love. Thank you for welcoming me into your family with open arms and loving me the way that you do. To Paul, Zachary, who bugged me for months about dating Todd. I appreciate that because you knew long before we did, even though I wanted to hurt you every day. You pushed me, and you opened my eyes to see the man of my dreams. Today you made my dreams come true. Thank you for loving me the way that you do, supporting me when I need you, and for making me feel like the most important woman in the world. For those of you that know me, my life hasn't always been very easy. But with you by my side, I feel like I can conquer anything. And you make me feel very safe. I feel like I can face anything with you by my side. I'm most grateful for that. It makes me so proud to be your wife. We had a crazy forever kind of love, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life together with you. I love you. Way to boob grab me in front of all these people. Keep it clean.
You guys get that on video?
Thank you very much, all of you, for coming. I also want to thank Penny. I don't know where she is, if she's up here. For those of you that don't know, this this planning was a little difficult for us. And I thought I was going a little Bridezilla. And I went crazy on the hotel. And Penny is like an angel sent from above. And today would not have happened without her. And it was perfect in every way. And I love you and I thank you. And you're a stranger to me, but you are an amazing woman. And I can't wait to spend every year here. So thank you for that. I truly appreciate it. That's all I have to say. We love you.
A few more words.
Oh, no. Wait, anybody, was that Jamie's wedding? Okay. We might want to get food soon.
Let's make this quick and slick. You guys, honestly, just to reiterate what she said. Oh, I like that. Thank you all for coming. I mean, this means the world to us. Shut the fuck up, Paul. Your time's later, bud. Quick and slick,
sorry,
buddy.
For kids.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Hey, seriously, honestly, thank you guys all for coming. The people that know me, in my life, my aura, my everything, it's all about family and friends. And I love my family. I love my friends more than anything. And I know Rachel does the same. And I think that we are combining families and friends right now. And it's an amazing combination and intermix of everybody. And, you know, we're one big family now, and I'm so proud of everyone. I just can't believe the support, and I'm so happy you guys made it down here. And I wish that every single person here knew how much they meant to us. And I cannot say that, there's not words to explain our feelings for that. We're blessed and touched by every one of you, and there is a reason that you guys are our friends. You know, we're born with our family, so we're stuck with those people.
Some of mine are here.
But you know what? I just love all you guys, and I just, like I said, individually, the support and everything that you mean to us, it's over the top amazing, and I cannot even say how much you guys mean to me. And Rachel and I are so happy to have you here. And it's going to be a joyous time for the rest of our lives. And we can't wait to share it with you guys. And we love you guys. And
I've said enough.
Thank you.
We, the family, truly, truly love and appreciate Rachel. And when she came into our life a little over a year ago, we knew when she walked in the door with Todd on his birthday, July 17th, we knew that this woman was meant for Todd, truly, and I've never seen him happier. And he did share with me that he almost thought his opportunities had passed him by, wasn't really ever going to really happen for him, because he was never really struck this hard by anybody. And he said at one point, that's the way I talk. But he on.
Yeah, why don't we do that?
It was really going to be short and sweet, but it's gone on twice as long. But the important thing was, he said, you were right, Mom, forever. You'll know when you know. And that's what I always told him. And he said, you're right. The minute I met her, I knew. And I was so happy. So happy that it was Rachel, and she was in our life, and she's been in our life, and this works out so well with our family. We just love you so much. And so looking forward to the amazing places you two will go.
I have to say like 12 more words. I'm so happy to have this woman as my wife right now. She looks absolutely amazing. I am so silly lucky. I cannot be happier. There's not words to express my feelings right now. I love you, Rachel.
Both could live. If I was a sculptor, But then again, no, or a man who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. And you can tell everybody this is the song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind what I put down in the words. How wonderful life is while you're in the world. I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind what I put down in the words. How wonderful life is while you're.